have been made today as we celebrate this feast of Mary's Assumption. Mary's Assumption to heaven to be with our Lord and our God. We gather now to offer praise and thanks to God, choosing this lowly person, given the great responsibility that she has as our mother now, as Mother of the Church. So let's join together now in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The love of God our Father, the grace of the Lord Jesus, peace and the strength of the Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
As we come together in faith, let us be mindful of our need for God's mercy and the Lord's forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are Son of God, and yet you are Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us join now in our praise of God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ,
reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the Ark of His covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon beneath her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns. And on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God, and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. My brothers and sisters, Christ has been risen from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all died, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in a proper order, Christ the first fruit. Then, at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty, every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
His servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord. Father Ron said in his opening remarks today, notwithstanding that it's a Sunday, we celebrate the great feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary into heaven. And perhaps we could pause for a few moments this afternoon to reflect about this woman about whom we know really so little. And yet she has intrigued humanity for over 20 centuries. She has perdured, as they say. We don't know where she was born or when she died, but we do know some of her family and friends from Scripture. Why then has the appeal of this woman been so persistent throughout the ages, right up until our own day? Came across a piece this past week by the noted author, Father Bill Bosch, and he suggested that the answer to this might have to do with her human journey with God. Mary's human journey with God, which is also our human journey. And so right away, we've got a kinship with Mary. And so, through the eyes of Father Bill Bosch, let's take a brief tour, as we might, into Mary's life in Scripture and reflect on how does that speak to us in our own lives in the year 2021. We first meet Mary when she's engaged to Joseph, and then the ugly rumors started. She was pregnant without a husband. And no one believed her when she said she had conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit. They must have laughed at her. And even Joseph seriously considered abandoning her. Throughout the ages, people who have suffered from false rumors, people who have had their reputation soiled and ruined unjustly, people who have been misunderstood and maligned, unwed mothers, have all identified with Mary right from the very beginning of her story in Scripture. And then we meet Mary at the birth of Jesus when the shepherds and the angels rejoiced, and yet those in power sought to kill her baby and to snuff out his life-giving spirit. Yes, parents of every age can identify with Mary's plight as their children are faced with, and I love this term that Father Bosch uses, soul assassins, those who would assassinate the soul, those who, among other things, lure people into believing that they do live on bread alone. And then we meet Mary when she and her family are forced to flee to Egypt to become refugees in a strange land, displaced and homeless. She joins those countless refugees who trod the earth in our day, looking for homes, the lowly who need to be lifted up. Parents can identify with Mary because she lost her child in a big city. Doesn't your heart just go out anytime you're in a mall and you see a mother who's lost her child. There's something that tugs deep within us, and yet Mary lost her child. She becomes every parent, every teacher, every mentor who just can't communicate with teenagers, every parent who just can't seem to communicate with their children. They've lost their child, in a sense, to the lure of addictions of every kind that our society holds before their eyes. Yes, Mary has been there. And then we meet widow Mary, as her son leaves her behind and goes out on his mission, goes out through the door, and suddenly every parent who has witnessed this bitter, sweet time in their lives, that time of letting go, feels Mary's heart. She's with us. And then her son is caught by the authorities, betrayed by a person she's had over for dinner on many occasions. And then she sees her son beaten and humiliated and hung upon a cross. And yearning to be close to him, she's told by the soldiers, no, you need to stay off at a distance. You need to stay away. And then every parent who has seen their child suffer on a cross of any kind, a cross of alienation or addiction or abuse, every parent who is told to keep your distance can identify with Mary and suffer and pray in silence. And finally, we find Mary cradling her dead son in her arms, that wonderful Michelangelo sculpture of the Pietà, sobbing uncontrollably. And she is once more every parent who has lost a child, every friend who has lost a friend to violence, senseless violence of any kind. This is the ageless woman whom we honor and venerate today, who has given us a legacy, a companion on our human journey. Son, Jesus said, behold thy mother. Jesus says to us, behold thy mother. Mary was unblessed in various and sundry ways during her lifetime, and yet she remained faithful. She clung to God. She clung to God even when she couldn't understand. And the church, honor her this day because she took the lowly path. And she relied upon the one who would lift her up. She relied upon the one who would feed her, just as we do. It is the Lord who has done great things for her, lifting her while she was down. And that's why all generations call her blessed. The message of this feast is that Mary is a sign of hope for all of us who cling to God. And I hope that we all do simply cling to God amid our fears, our doubts, our inability to understand why sometimes the mystery of God. Yet Luke teaches us, blessed are those who believed what was spoken by the Lord, that what the Lord had said would be fulfilled.
Let us join now in proclaiming the faith that we share. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Confident of God's care, God's love, and God's mercy, let us come before the Lord now as we offer our prayer and our petition.
We invite our response. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray this day for the Church of God, the people of God. May we continue to grow in faith as we hearken to God and trust in God's will, just as Mary did. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who lead our world, all who find themselves in positions of authority. May they listen to the Spirit of God and do what is just, leading all people by their good example. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this day, as we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, who is taken up into the glory of heaven with body and soul, we pray that we may always strive after heavenly ways and so share in her glory. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray this day and always for mothers everywhere, that they experience God's loving care for them and transmit that love to their children. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all college students who are starting to begin their academic year, and for those who will support them in their studies, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for all of those who are sick. We pray for the homebound, the hospitalized, the institutionalized. May they know God's love through their caregivers as well as our own hospital care ministers. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of those who have been reborn into eternal life with you, O Lord. We pray in particular this day for William Lawrence, who died over the past few days. We remember in a special way Marjorie Bacon, Norma Coates, and Raymond Franklin. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Lord, we offer to you all of these intentions, together with all of the intentions that reside within the silence of our hearts. O Lord, may you find them pleasing in your sight. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Most loving and gracious God, we pray that you accept the prayers that we raise in faith this day. We pray that we may continue to know the care of Mary, the mother of your Son. Make our prayers always through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Please stand and pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this offering, our tribute of homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts, aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
Amen.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus our Lord. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your church coming to perfection, and as a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy, we proclaim. Mystery of faith. Son, Jesus Christ. us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And